What is going on, guys? Welcome back. Comment here for you. Interesting video sent over from a viewer. So not the best quality, maybe not the quality standard you've seen on my channel, but a conversation I want to have because it comes down to a couple things. Number one, difficulty level. Let's say you are playing on the easiest setting and the game is going to give you a touchdown and this is how they do it. Or let's flip that around and say you're playing on the hardest difficulty setting and the computer is going to get a touchdown and that is how they do it. I guess how that's perceived changes how you see this game as a player. So first of all, you can see number 50 not in a good position to make a tackle. So behind the running back, you have a suction tackle take effect. The corner comes down. He tries to engage. There's no multiple tackles in this game, so 54 can't branch into anything. And then all of a sudden, the ball carrier kind of rolls up and then takes off down the field. Now, obviously, you know, given the circumstance of what you've seen before, he's going to score. But it's an interesting concept to say, well, the game difficulty caused this. Because to me, you can certainly say that. But the bigger picture is the lack of quality in this game much more directly affected that, in my opinion. Because if you're going to have multiple tackles broken, fine. Have multiple tackles broken and lead to a touchdown. Why does it have to be branching animations, motion shifts, create a scenario where a player breaks free? Can a player roll off another defender, get up and continue to running? Absolutely. Is that a motion capture that was done there to showcase that? No, it was just the game having poor physics and levitating a player up. So while I understand when people watch the game, they use a lot of different things to kind of self-justify what happened, difficulty settings being one of them. But I think if we're more critical of the problems the game has and the problems that create the scenarios we're actually seeing, then we can certainly still want those moments, those multiple broken tackle runs, or those runs where you're just going to have a player break free and go for 60 yards. But we need to have them in a way that's tangible, that's realistic, that can constantly be repeated. You're not always going to see a player levitate up like that, but you should always be able to see a player break 4, 5, 6 tackles if they're that good of a player. And I think that's where Madden really struggles. Even with superstar players and players trying to feel different, it just doesn't toe that line of creating realistic gameplay experiences every single time, and instead more likely generating one-off scenarios based on a lot of broken or dated gameplay engines, in my opinion, that impact the game negatively. I'd love to know your thoughts on this. Appreciate you checking out. I will be back very shortly with more commentary.